Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Today I'm going to make my easy beasy butternut squash soup. For this, you need 2 butternuts, 2 carrots, 2 celery, 1 yellow onion, a Granny Smith apple, and 4 tablespoons of butter, 1 cup of heavy whipping cream, a little bit black pepper and sea salt, olive oil, 1 teaspoon of curry powder, which I have measured over here, and some chicken stock that I pre-made. And also as a tool, you need some knives, of course, spoon, peeler, measuring cups and spoons, and blender if you have. If you don't, then just use your smasher. All right, let's get started. Of course, you'll cut the butternut squash in half and take off the seeds. So for this, you're gonna use your spoon to carve out the seed part. And you don't need this, so you're going to dispose. Just like this. I have this tool that I'm going to use for my olive oil. And you're gonna roast the butternut so that the soup will taste nice and roasty. About 1 teaspoon. About this much oil. The 4 teaspoon butter. Thank you. nice and buttery. Smells so good. Now it's time to add that 1 teaspoon curry powder and a little bit black pepper for your taste. I add 2 pinches, or maybe all of them. It's about 1/8 teaspoon, and a little bit sea salt for your taste. And again, I got 2 pinches, another 1/8 teaspoon. And then once it's nicely roasted, I'm going to add my frozen chicken stocks in here. Smells nice because now there's a curry powder and black pepper. The scent is so beautiful, very aromatic. I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of brown sugar and the soup stocks. Four minutes to go, and the soup is getting melty. If you notice that this is actually meatless soup, it has chicken stock and Granny Smith apple, celery, carrots, and yellow onions. Other than that, it's pretty much vegetarian soup.
Who's here? Come here. Aww. Show me your cute feet. Let me see, paw. No? He's a sun dog. He bathes in the sun. Poor thing has very poor feet. Do you wanna go out again? Yeah? Let me see. Come here. No? He loves sun.
Meanwhile, my butternut squash is baking. I'm cooling down the sauteed vegetable with the chicken stock so that when I blend it, it's cooler and blends it smoothly.
High stakes action. Although real Smurfs stand only 3 feet tall, 3 apples tall, in today's Big Apple, this balloon flies 4 stories tall. See, Chocolate Factory is open for business. The Ferris wheel-like machine delivers 2 times the joy. 1 half of the egg has a delicious chocolate cream, and the other features a surprise toy. This special combination of discovering a toy with a sweet treat makes Kinder Joy the perfect gift this holiday season.
Singing "I Want a Hippopotamus for Christmas" from his new album, A Very Darren Christmas, is Emmy and Golden Globe Award winner Darren Criss.
Chimney flue, spring him through the front door. That's the easy thing to do. I can see me now on Christmas morning, creeping down the stairs. Oh, what joy, what surprise, when I open up my eyes to see a hippo here go stare.
It's been 20 minutes. Let's check it in. It's not quite ready.
It's not quite ready, so I'm going to cook it another 20 minutes and we shall see. Put it back. The cooking time is actually 1 hour. I'm trying to reduce that by half. So start. Ooh, looking nice. It's not quite soft yet, so I'm going to cook another 20 minutes. All I'm looking for is nice soft consistency.
Need to boil it for 10 minutes so that butternut squash gets really smooth and soft, and then after that we're going to cool it down and blend it in a blender. Time to blend. spatula is really good to scrape down every juice and stuff out of the pot. And for this, I'm using the wide angled spatula. And later, I'm going to use smaller, thinner ones. This is the thinner, round angled one. It's easy to get to the bottom of this blender and get the blended smooth butternut squash soup out of it. All right, this is how it looks like. So now we're going to bring it back to the heat and reduce the heat down a little bit. Half the way down. And before it boils and bubbles, I'm going to add that 1 cup of heavy whipping cream. So it becomes nice, smooth texture. We don't need to boil this, but we're going to warm it up, heat it up, and taste for the seasoning. If the salt is a little too low, you can add salt and anything to you for your taste. Looks very nice. Remember, you don't need to boil this, it's just going to reheat with the cream blended in it. Look how beautiful it is. So now you can see it's about to bubble up and boil, therefore I'm going to turn it off. Otherwise when it boils, it will be like a volcano lava. It's going to pop up. Oops, there. Time to turn off the heat. See, that's bubbling right there. Alright, this is it. This is the beautiful butternut squash soup for, all right, this is it, my butternut squash soup for the holidays. It can be eaten for beautiful Thanksgiving holidays and Christmas holidays. For my final touch, I add a little bit chives on top of the soup just for the color and the beautiful scent to it. And that's it, my friends. Happy Thanksgiving. Cheers. Thank you for watching Making Easy Butternut Squash Soup. If you like my video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. This will help me to create more videos and also keep in touch with you. And here's to you. Cheers. So yummy. Very smooth, creamy. Happy holidays. See you later.